Hey guys, so we got this in the shop and we got to change out the head unit. When we're working on the vehicles, besides putting some sort of protective film on the door jams, especially when we're getting in and out of the vehicles all the time, we also like to put it on a small little trickle charger to help keep the battery fully charged, because discharging a battery completely is very hard on it. Plus, when you're working there, you need to test things. You want to make sure that everything's healthy. So we put this flip out in a while ago and it's finally given it up. I'm not sure if the ribbon cable's damaged or if it has no power, so we have to get the head unit out and then we can check all the wiring to make sure that we have power ground accessory. All right, out with the old, here's the new one. So we have soldered and shrink tube everything as usual. I have lots of room in the dash, so what I'm going to do is I decided this fuse over here is out of the chassis. It's pretty long and they usually get you to fold it out. If I don't have much room, I leave this long and I tuck it down low. I want to get my harness as tight as possible, and if I have the room, I will cut it and move it over here closer to the head unit. So on these units, you can actually have the screen further out or push it back in. I'm going to try to push it further in. So we just have to take these screws out over here. There's top and bottom. This mounting bracket will go back into the chassis and get us closer to the dash. These Vipers aren't too bad to work on. So we just released this panel. We put tape down so we don't scratch anything up. And then you can see here that we have changed out the mounting kit because I want to be able to use the ISO mount brackets that come with this kit. Here I see the old traditional flip out versus our Halo 9, and you can see that 2 inches makes all the difference. Comment below and tell me what you guys think. Okay, all our harnessing's ready to go, all tested taped. We can tuck this nicely. And there's just gobs of room in this dash. Manufacturers, if you're watching this, make your dashes like this. Put room in here so I can do stuff like this. It's almost done, just gotta put the last fasteners in. And then we can go ahead and test this thing. All right, we're fired up and we have our head unit hooked up to our phone. As you can see here, we have all of the features that are allowable to use while you're driving. So this deck does not have a dedicated onboard GPS system. It will use your phone, but it doesn't use that much data. Always check with your provider on the data plan. But what's nice is it's much faster when it comes to figuring out where you want to find locations, and we can also use the phone to track everything. Okay, let's go ahead and try using Apple CarPlay.
Find Vision's electronics.
Okay, one option I see nearby is Vision's electronics on King George Boulevard.
So we can see here, based on our GPS position, it's going to show us a list and what's closest to us. Let's say we don't know what we want. Find the closest gas station.
The closest one I found is 80th and King George service on King George Boulevard.
Find the closest restaurant.
The closest one I see is Lighthouse Fresh and Tasty, which averages 3 stars. Let me know if you would like to hear more information.
So it's super intuitive, which is what I like, because this way we can tell it what we want. Let's say we're in an area, we're trying to figure things out. Another thing I like is we can also text. Text Anthony.
What do you want to say?
Hello.
Your message to Anthony says, hello. Ready to send it?
Send.
I'll send your message.
So let's say you're doing an important business deal, or you're just trying to get stuff done, or you forgot to tell someone, like, hey, can you lock the door? You can go ahead and text someone while you're driving and it'll do it all for you.
Hey Siri. Find Vision's electronics.
Okay, one option I see nearby is Vision's electronics on King George Boulevard.
So you guys can see that we can do full voice command as well. It might be hard to do that depending on the type of vehicle, if it's noisy. Also, we had the Apple Watch hooked up and the phone was giving the Apple Watch priority, so we had to disconnect that too. So you have to consider all the devices that you're using. I actually just prefer to hold the home button, and that way it senses me right away and it's listening. As you can see, as I'm talking, it's trying to pick up what I'm saying. Let's see what it does after.
I don't understand, and I wait to census me right away in a talking to try to pick up I'm saying after.
For the installation itself, it was pretty straightforward. Now, the reason why you saw me use those brackets before, because I need to be able to service this and want to be able to take it in and out within reason. If you use a traditional cage, which you can, if you have some old Alpine cages around, you can lock it in. However, it'd be incredibly hard to get your keys in here. And the way that this kit is, you can't get at the screws that easily to take it out. So we have to keep serviceability in mind. But for the most part, it goes in like an aftermarket head unit. Also, it works perfectly fine with the Alpine sound system that already came with this car from the factory. We did have to lower it, so we came down as low as we could so we don't disturb the HVAC controls. Also, we're going to use the shifter right now, and we just clear the screen. Obviously, there's going to be some compromises when you're putting in a screen this large and minimizing how much fabrication that you have to do. Now, on some vehicles, the vents maybe get covered, but the old flip-out did cover them, so by lowering it, we still have the vents accessible over here. I can still adjust it, and I did try running the engine, and it did blow cold air. We had the AC on. It was blowing cold air, so we didn't sacrifice too much comfort in this. And when you have a screen this large in a car like this, like, who cares? It's a Viper ACR. We just want to look cool. The other thing that I like about this install, it's kind of a coincidence. This vehicle came with a factory Alpine sound system, and it's now back to having an Alpine head unit. So at least when you look around, the vehicle's got a nice touch. Typically what we have to do is if we change out the head unit to a different brand, if the customer is really particular, we would remove this and put just a blank grill on it or have to put the new logo on so that way everything's matching. Most people don't care, but sometimes when you're trying to make little changes and little touches, these things do matter. It's all about the little thing. So there is an external microphone in the windshield. And you see here we have factory loom, and we've loomed our Bluetooth mic wire, and we've tucked it all up under the dash. That way you don't see anything. That way it just looks like there's nothing amiss. Everything came with the vehicle as much as possible. Bluetooth microphones, I tried to either put them in the center of the headliner or in the gauge cluster. It really depends on the vehicle. I don't like putting them on the column. I've done it once in a great while because I have to, but I've tried not to. I think it looks cheap. Here it works, and I like to have it in the center of the vehicle if you're putting it up here, because if the windows are open, you don't want to get a bunch of wind noise. Also, when I see the microphones over there, well, you put down your sun visor and then you cover it. Those are the top reasons why I place them in the center. Plus, I think it looks better. So you see behind, we get really close to the dash. We have to notch the kit a bit to make it all fit and to get it to go as far in as possible. And it looks like any newer car. You guys, in my last video, you've seen like Mercedes is doing this, Mazda's doing this, but this screen's way larger, and you've seen how quickly...
To whom should I send your message?
It responds to inputs with the screen and with my voice command. It really rivals iPads, in my opinion, as far as how you interact with the screen. Like, we did not calibrate anything on this screen. We just started using it, and it just senses your finger input very well. You guys might also want to notice that as we're touching the screen, it doesn't really move. Alpine spent a lot of time to develop a screen that when it mounts in there, it's nice and solid. It feels like a factory unit. So what do you guys think? Right now, this is pretty much one of the biggest aftermarket screens on the market. In my books, it has the fastest reaction time to physical input on your fingers. Now, obviously, we did have to compromise a bit, so we do cover the vents. Some people really care about that. I don't, especially on a car that this is not a daily driven car. It's really rare you're going to have the windows up, but they still do work as far as the vents go. Now, some people might be concerned about the shifter. See my hands on the front. I'm not hitting the screen. If I were to be very careless, I would. So, you know, usually on most upshifts, though, like, I tend to go like that. But you can see from second to third is usually the most times you are going to be very aggressive. So second, and I'm not hitting the screen. These are things that we have to consider. And this is where we had to do a lot of the adjustments. So we had to go to the farthest setting to go all the way in. We had to tilt the screen. We had to adjust it for height. That way we wouldn't control we wouldn't cover the HVAC, but then still also have some of the vents coming out at us. These are all things that we have to factor in. Obviously, most vehicles are automatic sold nowadays and don't have the shifter this close to the screen, but it is going to work, and I think it looks really good. Comment below, guys. What do you guys think about this? If you like today's content, make sure to check out my channel and hit the subscribe button and make sure to hit that bell notification. What that does is it makes sure that you're always kept up to date with all the content that we're providing with you guys on YouTube. So the way that we have the channel set up is I have the uploads up top. That way at all times, you can always see, if you just hop by the channel, what our latest upload is. Plus with the bell notification, you're going to get some sort of message from YouTube itself. We also have popular uploads, car videos, how-to videos, demonstration, informational videos, and a lot of cool other specific car videos like our builds playlist. I really like the builds playlist because it takes all the theories from our how-to section and it keeps applying it to different vehicles.